How's it going?
Pretty good.
No, it's been a while since I've seen you.
Yeah.
Summer Institute, the summer, we're together.
Manhattan. 6 long weeks.
I know, they went by super fast.
Yeah.
I know, like, personally, like, one of my favorite moments, like, there were a lot the summer, but one of my personal, like, favorite moments was the last day. When we, like, all gifted each other, so, like, when folks would come up and present, like, either a flower or, like, made something of significance to, like, give that person for how they impacted them during that summer.
I remember I was crying so much because it was so emotional. Only because with St. Ash, everything is so intentional. When you pick your name out of that box and you're like, okay, this is the person I'm getting a gift for, there's really a meaning behind the gift. It's not just something that's vague and generic. You really know that it's coming from a place of love and community. I built sisterhood with people that I didn't know before Sadie Nash, which is crazy because from 6th grade up until 10th grade, I was in the same school with the same types of people that I never got the chance to talk to, but in 6 weeks, I was able to build community with people that I never met before Sadie Nash.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really a safe space where I was brave enough to grow at my own speed and learn at my own pace with people that supported me from a place of love.
I need a second to slip that. That was so beautiful. No, I definitely like feel you on that. I think one of the beautiful things and the most rewarding things of being a dean is like being able to see your all's like progress, right? And being able to see folks grow at their own pace and ask questions not only of themselves but things around them and people around them, and not only like be really fruitful and grow but also supporting each other and seeing y'all grow together, and with the gift like it not being materialized and being intentional and having to do something for a person that doesn't require money, that doesn't require a lot of time, and having you appreciate them in a way that maybe you haven't appreciated them like verbally in the space.
Yeah. I definitely agree. There were so many amazing moments. I remember going into my power identity privilege class and like, yes, every day my mind was blown. I definitely remember my first day. I was very shy. I was very insecure about, you know, not knowing the answers to the question that was posed in the group. But like, it was such a safe space where I was able to ask questions where I wasn't called stupid or ashamed about, you know, why don't you know that? I think another thing that really stood out for me was the fact that knowledge wasn't hoarded. It was in the dean's best interest to like actually educate their Nashers. They really actually wanted to see us prosper. And I feel like that's not something that's tangible in other spaces.
Yeah.
So I really appreciated that, and that really resonated with me.
And I think like, you know, personally for me and the deans that I worked with, is like sharing our knowledge was definitely one of the things that we wanted to do, not only like based on what you all like as Nashers were asking questions and topics you all were interested in, but also things that we were skilled with. So like whether it was like having a workshop for folks about like gentrification, or whether it was about Addie doing a workshop about sisterhood and some of the challenges of like feeling a sisterhood in like communities of all women, or like de-puzzling like Despacito.
Mm-hmm.
The song Justin Bieber. Did you go to that workshop?
Yes, it was like amazing because we touched on all different songs, and it's like you never really, at least personally for me, I never really interpret what I'm listening to a point where I'm like, wow, why are women being sexualized so much? Or where is this anti-blackness coming from? Colorism, like, whoa, in my face. So it was like really enlightening overall and inclusive of the fact that, you know, not a lot of people have the tools to know as much as the next person. So we use our community to build each other. I really think Sadie Nash made up the phrase, like, it takes a village to raise a child. Boy, was everyone like teaching me, nurturing me. Yeah.
Like, what would you say, like, was your one big takeaway from the summer? I know it's a lot, it's like a big question, but like, if you could like sum it up.
Summing it up, my one big takeaway. So during the summer, I wasn't really sure if I would, you know, go through with Sadie Nash. I was going through a lot of my personal life. I was struggling with my mental health, but I was like, you know, let me just take a chance and just try it, get that exposure. And I remember feeling like I was never ignored, which is something that I never really feel because I'm very quiet. I didn't really take up much space. I didn't, you know, bother anyone. But it's like people initiated conversation with me. Like they took time out of their day. Like they went out of the way to make sure, look, we're gonna talk to you. Even the mailboxes that were set up and decorated, you know, with the warm and fuzzies, affirmations, I always had an affirmation, like, nothing was overlooked. So, as far as materially, I kind of was struggling with my wardrobe. I would wear the same sweatpants every now and then, you know, same round of t-shirts. And it was just so touching that, you know, the deans actually noticed that and provided me with the funds so that I can get some new clothes, some new shoes on my feet. Wow. I think that stuck with me the most because they actually noticed, even though I didn't take up that much space.
Can I give you a hug?